The Cornelius Ryan Book Award is sponsored by the Friends of Richard Threlkeld, and it goes to Evan Osnos for his book, Age of Ambition, Chasing Fortune, Truth, and Faith in the New China. It's published by Farrar, Straus, and Giroux. The book is a powerful look into the soul of China as 1.3 billion inhabitants clamor for economic and spiritual success after decades of deprivation. Here from Washington, except his third OPC award, is Evan Osnos. The citation is awarded to Jack Fairweather for The Good War, Why We Couldn't Win the War or Peace in Afghanistan, published by Basic Books.
Thank you very much. It's a great privilege, I have to say, to be here tonight in the name of Cornelius Ryan and the values that he stood for. He was famous for writing three cinematic books about World War II. They made movies about them, they were a huge success. But what a lot of people don't know, I certainly didn't know until recently, is that he was a huge evangelist for the power of reporting over writing, for shoe leather over the pyrotechnics on the page. He told these great nonfiction tales, but what mattered to him most was that he had conducted, by his count, 16,000 interviews in the course of reporting his books. In a letter to a friend, he wrote, quote, "You may think this is all a kind of madness, an obsession, and I suppose it is," unquote. As foreign correspondents, we've often had the job of recording the memory that people in other countries are not permitted to record themselves. In many places, that means writing about war and dissent. And in China, where I've spent most of the last decade, it means also writing about the world's fastest accumulation of wealth. It's about who is winning and who's losing and who's setting the rules and who's breaking the rules and the tensions that that's creating for the future. Tonight, I'd like to acknowledge the enormously brave local journalists, Chinese journalists, who work under great pressure to report as aggressively as they can on wealth and power. But the risks for them are immense, and that's where we come in. As correspondents who enjoy the freedom to write what we know, we have a responsibility to do it, not only for our readers, but for the sake of reporters who don't enjoy the same privilege. So thank you to The New Yorker magazine and to Farrar, Straus, and Giroux for supporting this book, and to my wife, Sarah Beth, for supporting that and everything else.